you learn and the more you share what you've learned about these guys, the better chance they have to survive. So you guys were such awesome listeners. Go ahead and put your hands straight up. Give yourself a pat on the back. I'll pat Jasmine. And since you were such awesome listeners, how many of you guys would like to meet Jasmine? Okay, I thought so. All right, you guys. What? I had a kinkajou. I had a body.
Now I would like to lead us all in a rendition of a song I'm sure is one of your favorites, in Diesenheilig in Holland, okay? In Diesenheilig, no, I'm just kidding you. Just kidding, it's from a thing called the Magic Flute. You're gonna have to check it out later. That's how we make a splash at your local library. Thank you very much, all right. But anyway, without further ado.
The part of the show that I like the very least, and I highly recommend that you never even think of fooling around with this. It has been my misfortune to have acquired this strange ability. And then certain cretinous people actually have provided me with financial remuneration in compensation for performing this strange affliction. It has caused me to speak in a weird fashion. I refer, of course, to the ancient, esoteric, and frequently disgusting art of sword swallowing.
Gotta admit, that one's kind of rancid. One thing's for sure, my mama didn't make this. Holy mackerel. Okay, let's go to spin this plate on here. Oh, yeah?
It has a hole in it.
Let's watch our clothes. There we go. Cool. Thank you. Holy mackerel. That would go all the way down to my stomach. Let's forget about this one. Don't you think?
Yeah.
Just forget about it, right? Yeah. Oh, eat it. You don't really want to me swallow this one.
Yeah.
Holy mackerel.
Let's just talk about
it. I'll tell you one. Oh, that's a little better. Actually, wait a second. Oh. I think it has a faint hint of Pooh's Cafe. I don't even know what that is. But I think there's a faint hint with overtones of raspberry. It's actually very delectable. No, it's not. It's horrid. It's horrid. Well, tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to swallow this sword. It's going to go into my stomach. I'm going to bow just like that. Here we go, my young friends. We've lost my microphone capability. Oh, holy man, I gotta be more careful. We lost my microphone. Is this the microphone right here, this part? Okay, so I just hold, is that fine? I just hold it like this. There we go. Well, unfortunately, it stayed until the very, and somewhat, I must say, bitter end. Oh, that last one, I gotta tell you, was like, oh, it was awful.
Well, this next song is about surfing. And it was actually recorded by a group called the Beach Boys. Have you ever heard of the Beach Boys? Do you know where they went to high school? Hawthorne, right. So, not in this building, but yeah, down the street. But this one, I want you guys to act like you're surfing or dancing. But so stand up. Everybody stand up and show me what it looks like when you're surfing.
If everybody had an ocean across the USA, you gotta move. Everybody be surfing like California. You'd see them wearing the baggies, Arachi sandals too. A bushy, bushy Montego, serving USA. You get a burger at Del Mar, the Durham County Line. Santa Cruz and Drexel, I said there on me. Down Tahiti Lake, everybody's gone surfing. life in USA. Everybody's gone surfing, surfing USA.
My friend Lori Buckner wrote a song about swimming fish. And that's a little fish were sleeping on a rock in the bottom of the ocean.
Everyone lift up your heads.
They lifted up their heads. And they shook out their tails.
Let's go swimming.
And they said, let's go swimming. Let's go swimming. Let's go swimming.
The Snake Who Would Not Bend. And my name's Rob Fulcher, and I wrote it. Yeah. Once there was a snake who would not bend his way in a slow, straight line. Finally, when he got there, he would bend his neck down ever so slightly, which was the only bending he ever would do, just enough to take a sip. Turned from blue to black. The moon rose and turned the sky purple, and the snake began to dream. His dream filled the sky with big wide swirls and little tiny curlicues. He tried to escape his dream by rolling over in his sleep, but he was too stiff to roll. Then it fell to the water with a bloop, and it made a ripple. As the snake looked down, his body in the water mirror began to bend very softly in the ripple the tear had made. He gasped in wonder. "I'm bending," he cried. "That's me. I can see myself bend." Tears of joy poured from his eyes and fell to the water, sending his water body leaping and dancing in the bending of the rippling. He bent down into the dancing, bending, rippling water and drank long and strong from the heart of it. He lifted his head and closed his eyes. He moved his head to the left and to the right. He felt his brand new bending wiggle down his neck, woggle down his body, and jiggle all the way to the tip of his tail. He felt the rough, hot ground scritch and scratch against his sliding, swerving belly. He felt his mouth curve upward into a big, bendy smile. He opened his eyes and slithered away, coiling and twisting, sliding and bending to play with his bendy friends. The end.
There we go. I would like my friend right up there. Almost worked. There it is. Can you see it? What's in the center? What shape is it? I made a square bubble. But it's in there. What's going to happen to it when I blow it?
It's going to pop.
It's going to turn into a what? Let's find out if it turns into a circle or a square. What does it turn into?
A circle.
Keep blowing. Don't pop them.
Dinosaur sneeze. Countdown with me. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Dinosaur! Awesome! Go.
Wow.
There it is. Now spin in a circle. No, I'm just kidding. No, I'm just kidding. Now let me try it. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. We need more air. We need more air than what Rocket Robbie can do. That's a good try. This is what we're going to do. Amanda, you come on over here, put your two hands like that, and we're going to use my hairdryer again. Gosh, guys, sorry I'm showing you awesome science. Oh, my goodness. All right. It's not a leaf blower, it's a hairdryer. All right, Amanda, are you ready?
It's a leaf blower.
Dylan and Bryce, are you guys ready?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Get ready. Like my mummy now. Yeah, very cool. Let's give Dylan and Bryce a big. Oh, we need a photo shot. Can we go over there? Look up. Bryce. Why are you guys pulling up my. You guys are troublemakers. Bryce, look at the camera. There we go. Excellent.
About me? You never know what might be, dude. Oh, wow. Let's find a seat, sweetie. You were an excellent helper with those creatures. Later, guys. It's time for a new cruise so we can meet somebody else here in the show. It's time for an animal that has a head, a tail, 4 legs, and their home on their back. That dude, Tuck, is an African sulcata tortoise. But who do you know? He's getting pretty big. So he's going to use his arms. He pulls himself right up. His belly wiggles over like a snake. It's one hit pause. There it goes. All the way back inside and you did hit pause, didn't you? Okay, all the way. Back inside there, buddy. There we go. He made it.
One more time. Okay, all right, I can do maybe. Tell me your name. Yeah. Okay, I can do that. And I'm gonna add someone else's to it. What is your name?
Sean.
Matthew Sean. Okay, I'll do both. Gabin and Matthew, not the drum. De lula feto, da ola jagana. De te kumala. Gabin and Sean, not the drum. De lula jani go, da ola jagana. What was yours? Did you raise your hand? Tell me your name. Oh, I can do that. That's easy. Gabin and Philip, not the young. They lose the fit, those are all the young. You know I gotta do your name. What's your name? Gabin and Leilani, not the young. They lose the tiny cools, they're all the young. You know I'm coming for you. You knew I was coming for you. Tell me your name. Gabin and Ashley, not the young. They lose the tiny cools, they're all the young. Gabin and Ashley, not the young. Maria?
Maria?
Okay, look. I'm a little older than I was 20 something years ago, okay? Maria?
Maria?
Maria? Maria? Maria? Maria? Maria? Maria? Maria? Maria? Maria? Maria? Maria? Maria? Maria? Maria? Maria? Maria? Maria? Maria? Maria? Voy a cantar en español para ti. ¿Sí? No. Gabriel Mayer, nothing so. They lose the fit, those are all the time.
Now, every good portrait usually starts with the head, you know, realms, head centered to the paper.